I just wanted to get into some of the rationale and how that can benefit you. But let's look at a few reasons first on what, how does it benefit you, and what can you expect? What are ways this will help you? First big one in our culture is you can lose weight, and you can lose weight quickly and easily doing this. I would say that even if you don't really change the rest of your diet consciously, if you juice and you juice consistently in ways that we'll show you how to do tonight, and in significant amounts like we'll show you how to do, weight will come off. It's not going to be something you're going to have to stress about. You start putting good things in the body, your metabolism will change, your taste will change, the desire for other food, the emptiness, the never-ending, you know, bottomless pit in there, those things will change. So definitely helpful for weight loss. Arthritic pain, how does that work? We'll talk a little bit about that. If you have constipation, if you have bowel-related issues, it can be very, very helpful with that. Blood pressure, cholesterol, all the things we call metabolic syndrome in the modern world, you know, blood sugar, cholesterol, blood pressure, all those type of things. Those things can all be improved by juicing and by putting fruits and vegetables into the body. Type 2 diabetes specifically, that's a big one. I'll talk a little bit more about that specifically tonight. So if you have blood sugar problems, there's a reason for that. We're going to go into some specific stuff on how to start using juicing to do that safely, regardless of if you think you're sensitive to fruit or things like that. We'll go into that. Improving immunity in a general sense, so getting sick less often. Longer term, maybe less incidence of cancers, things like that. And then autoimmune disorders, which are things where you probably know people with lupus or rheumatoid arthritis or other things that are generally classified as an autoimmune thing, where your body's own immune system is supposedly attacking itself. Now, why would that be? Is there ways we can limit that cross-reaction of it doing that? Preventing disease in the future. That's what it's all about. There's a quote I always, probably almost everybody here seen from Thomas Edison. It says, "The doctor of the future will give no medicine, but he'll interest his patients in the care of the human frame, chiropractic, in proper diet and the cause and prevention of disease." And that's really, I like that quote. That sounds like chiropractic, and in fact, that's what he had in mind when he said that quote. So whether you knew it or not, when you came through that door tonight, you went through a time warp into the future. And this is what the future of healthcare will look like. This is what we do. So you went through a portal there. Hey, how'd that happen? Okay. Longevity. So can you actually live longer? Yeah, it's pretty clear that in all animal studies and everything that's ever been done, that if you concentrate the body and its tissues with nutrients and antioxidants and the things we'll talk about a little bit tonight, there is an increased lifespan. So everybody's heard of beta carotene, right? You get that in carrots, good for your eyes, it's a form of vitamin A. But there's a whole bunch of different carotene molecules and they're antioxidants. And they've done animal studies showing that animals who had the biggest predictor of longevity was the concentration in their body tissues of the carotenoid compounds in there. So potentially a factor in longevity there. And then the last thing is to cleanse or flush or detoxify the body. So just like, in coal plants these days, they design these scrubber chemicals to try and bind the metals and things that are being released during that process so they don't get into the water and into the air and things like that. They're designing that. Well, you have a buildup of toxic things in your body as well. And literally, the components of the fruits and vegetables, the colored molecules, those things in there, they're like scrubbers. They go in there and they bind all of these heavy metals and drugs, and they're non-specifically or specifically, and then they're going to bind to that, and then you can eliminate it through urine, through the bowel, and things like that. So it literally is a detoxifying or cleansing type of thing.